Becta?
Hello, Northern Lion.
Are you a man of culture? I'm listening to classical music.
I am, if by culture you mean listening to Ben Brunty's amazing soundtrack of FTL.
Yeah, I don't know who Ben Brunty is, but 3-2-1, good luck, have fun.
I said Ben Brunty.
Yeah, Ben Brunty.
Yeah. There you go. Northern Lion maintains a dominating 2-game lead now.
Tag yourself. What? Northern Nyan, Vin Sikta, that's a good one, Tear Baffy, Sock.
What are you talking about?
Sock, Re, Lyle.
Sock Le Bleu.
West, Lay, Golf. West, Lay, Golf, I guess.
What are you even talking about?
I'm just changing the first letters of all of... I'm swapping the first letters of the words in our names. Bodil Tisket.
But why?
Gathis Mames.
Oh my...
Dude, so we're gonna hit gold. This is how my brain works for humor. One, okay. First off, I'll just tell you straight up, Vin Sikta's pretty good.
I've been called Vin Sikta before.
Vin Sikta's good. I'm trying to think of who else could fit well.
Northern Nyan.
See, I already did that one.
Sounds like a very expensive brand clothes.
I already did that one.
Uh-huh.
So I'm just not sure why you're bringing it up, because I did it.
Because there's nothing else to do right now. There's nothing out here.
Yeah, it kind of sucks.
It's like the straightest.
Gandiesling is a classic as well.
Yeah, Gandiesling.
Fikel A.L. Mox. Or Fikel L.A. Mox.
That was, he was fun in XCOM. XCOM 2, actually.
Yeah, the second of the XCOM games.
Yeah, War of the...
Wait, did you play Muncho War of the Chosen?
Oh, I beat it, yeah. It was great.
I was going to say, I thought I was under the assumption.
Yep.
Monster Hunter Stories still takes the W for you.
Yep. War of the Chosen's up there for sure, though. Definitely up there. I think I would have given it to Battle Brothers if they had, like, followed through with, you know, all the developments. That game was fantastic. I wish Battle Chasers had turned out better than it was.
One of those games, like, I'm glad I waited on for, like, 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Because the first week, everyone was like, this is game of the year material. And then 2 weeks, everyone was like, eh.
Well, it's not that the game was bad. I think the music is the greatest standout in that game. That soundtrack is unbelievably good. Mm-hmm. But, like, I can't... And I want to make sure that I word this carefully, because I don't want to seem like, you know, YouTubers should dictate how games are programmed, but it's very hard to make a series out of games that, like, the dungeons take more than an hour to do.
Yes.
Agreed. Very difficult. Like, for roguelikes, like Isaac, for example, like, that's not that big of a deal, because you could have quick runs, you could have bad runs. I mean, that's the reason why I gave up Gungeon, was because the runs are just taking too long. But Battle Chasers, man, early on, those early game dungeons take... You know, doing like a 4-part series in one dungeon. I mean, that's difficult.
I completely agree. You don't have to tell me twice. Like, that's one of the main reasons I don't do series of specific games. You know, if people are like, hey, why don't you do a series on this? Odds are probably just too freaking long per video.
Yep.
Some of the time. I will say I'm interested in Battle Brothers, though.
Battle Brothers is great. I wish that they hadn't halted development on the game, because they had...
Development's halted?
Oh, no, yeah, they're done.
They're not making any more...
Nope. They updated it, and they're doing bug fixes. That's about it.
Oh, okay. So, wait, that doesn't mean development's done. That's...
Well, what is that? I mean, they said that they're...
Isn't that, the way that you said it, I kind of it felt like it was abandoned.
No, it's fully released.
I did not know that, actually.
Yeah, it released way back in, like, June or something. But the devs have come out and said that they're no longer going to be developing for the game.
Oh, I got 94 points.
Where'd you think we were?
Mexico.
Mexico, okay. Yeah, I mean, it's hard
and
to...
And I found a sign that said, like, Road 281. Which is the road that we were on.
Did you really? I didn't even see a road sign.
I saw that we were on Road 281, and there it is, Road 281 in Argentina.
Bamboozled, my friend.
Yeah, I got screwed pretty bad on that one.
Wait a second. What did that sign say? Oh, okay. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway.
We can't go in that direction.
Yeah, I noticed that as well. It's, we're Putin's horse ranches.
Oh, you think we're in Russia?
Something tells me we are.
Can I please click, or do we have to get through the truck way station first?
I think we actually have to go through the way station. I hate this. I actually...
Excuse me, sir. Do you mind if we search your car for capitalism?
We're actually going through the way station. Like, we gotta go around. What is this? That looks like... Okay, are you looking at the brown building that has yellow text on it?
No.
Okay, it's across the street.
The Google car is going into every business in this whole country.
Secret locations. They gotta suss out anything. Yeah, we are actually pulling off to the side of the road here.
I don't like to drive my car into the Russian gas station where we are. I do not like to drive my car in Russia.
Now we're going into like a hotel or something. Going to...
Oh, we passed a business, Invicta.
Oh, did you?
If you go fast enough, you can just bypass the business altogether.
Right, I'm furiously clicking here. Nope. That turned me around. I'm back in the parking lot. Don't listen.
Okay, this is a new one. I hit up and it sent me back. I didn't even know that was possible.
You hit down to jump.
I understand that reference. Yeah. You can just walk over it?
You can just walk over it. What an S load of F.
The angry video game nerd.
I have his autograph. Very proud
That's
of that.
That's pretty cool. He seems like a normal dude. He seems like a cool guy.
He's a huge Metallica fan, which made him even cooler in my book.
He seems sort of judgmental.
If you don't like Metallica, I can't be your friend.
I like some Metallica songs.
I think we've already talked about this before, but...
I really like Master of Puppets, a.k.a. Pastor of Muppets.
Uh-huh. Yep, that is actually the name of a font, by the way.
Pastor of Muppets?
Yeah, that's the name of the font that copies Metallica's like album or their logo. It's called Pastor of Muppets. I swear to God.
That's stupid.
I'm not the one who made it, but
I like Battery. I like Ride the Lightning. Mm-hmm. I like One. I do like Enter Sandman, even though I've heard it infinity times.
Yep, even though the band hates it.
It's just kind of like, it's like a good song.
I'm looking for the road, by the way.
Yeah, same.
Have you found it? Because I haven't.
I have not.
I'm hoping that, like, 7 means 5.
Yeah. You cling to that. I swear to you, I have seen Hebecno before.
Watch your language.
Hey, Invicta, ask me if I like Metallica's album Load.
Do you like Load?
Hebecno.
I can't be mad at that guess, but I'm a little mad.
I went straight for Moscow. Yeah, there you go. You got me by 150.
I can take it. I mean, I'm sorry. I have to rate it pretty high because... It said Machba, and it gave me the road number and direction.
I gave it a 2.
Look, unlike you, I'm not going to chastise your ratings over...
You know why I gave it a 2?
Why?
That would have been a 3, except for the wasted time going into every single gas station.
Yeah, but that doesn't really have anything to do with the location.
I think it does, because who knows what we would have found if we went another minute into the distance.
I guess that is kind of true. It's debatable. Anyway. I'm at 6384.
You got me by 2700 right now?
Oh no, Northern Line, I may not win this one. You still could come back.
But your character, you're doing a caricature of yourself. You're just saying what you say, but in a funny voice.
Oh, is that not what every YouTuber does?
That's a good point. That's not true. Some YouTubers have no self-awareness.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mathis. Welcome to Judge Mathis. Basal Sebastiao.
I like Judge Mathis. Sometimes Kate will put on some Judge Mathis, and I'll be like, I get it.
I sometimes, confuse myself if I'm watching Gerard the Completionist or Mathis.
I never got enough credit, okay, in my opinion.
I can't wait to hear this.
For the line in the live diss track, where, I don't even remember.
See you in the second verse, Mathis.
Yeah, but then it was like, hey, Mathis, or should I say Mike, or maybe Judge Mathis, or maybe Your Honor, will you even give me this video without a sponsorship offer?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I didn't want to take it to the extreme, but these days the only word on your lips is Madrene. And at some point it was I'm just not sure that what the world really needs is 200 guys reviewing the same 10 games from 1993. Yep. I was like, that's the best line in this whole rap.
It is.
And nobody gave that one any credit. I feel like I got too much credit for some of the lines, but I was like, that it's the greatest burn because it's so true.
I liked the one where he couldn't open his mouth without a sponsorship offer. That one was great.
It was also good, but even give me these 90 seconds without a sponsorship offer?
It was
these days I'm not even sure if you can even consume caffeine. When you open the can, the first and only ingredient's Madrene. I remember now. It's starting to come back to me.
It was a good live take. I mean,
thank you.
I don't know how much practice he did beforehand, but
4 hours. For real.
it was a golden age of content creation. I'm glad that everyone jumped on board.
Yeah.
I wasn't even planning on doing one. I straight
get
up
back
said,
to the chat. I'm gonna bring you one back. That was a classic.
Yeah, Cindy V. The Cindy V banger right there. I said before I even did it, I was like, because I mean I had BlizzCon literally 24 hours later. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I'm just not gonna do one. I don't really, it's not my thing, whatever. Then I was like, well, if I find a song, who would I do it after? And then I came up with the hook, and I was like, all right, well, I guess this is happening now. It was fun.
Yeah. Luke. It was a good time.
Man.
Hey, get off the road, buddy. This guy's got no shirt on.
Can't show that on YouTube.
Can't show that on YouTube. Can blow his brains out with a SKS from across the map.
Excuse me, that's
Don't you dare see his nipples.
Dude, I have no idea. That's extremely lucky. I should not have been rewarded with that. That is completely...
We guessed so close.
Really?
Yeah, I beat you by 70.
Yeah, I mean, that's pure luck. There's a place called Shin Gowara.
Yeah. It's the modern reboot of Gowara.
Pretty good. That's where Gowara...
the American company still owns the rights.
What are you at right now?
75.
Okay, I'm at 101. 09.
Okay. Yeah. See, 7,500 kind of works. 101, I'm not sure.
It's not the first time we've done this bit before. I give you a number that didn't quite make sense. It made sense in my head, but it didn't make sense coming out.
No, I feel you, yeah. We deleted the same number of columns, but
yeah.
I'm gonna be real with you. I don't know if I can beat you by 2,500 in this area of the world.
Probably not. I'm gonna not gonna lie. My heavy metal roots are fierce here.
Heavy metal Groots.
Yeah, I am heavy metal.
Sylvester Stallone in Guardians of the Galaxy. I'm Groot. Adrian. By the way. Very strange joke, because halfway through it, I remembered he is in Guardians of the Galaxy.
What?
He's in Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
Sylvester Stallone is?
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen any of them, so I just don't know.
He plays a space pirate.
I would not have ever known that until you told me that.
Do you know the main character of Guardians of the Galaxy?
It's Chris Pratt.
Yeah, but you know his character's name?
No.
He plays Star-Lord, a.k.a. Dreon Phaneuf. So, whenever Sylvester Stallone sees him, he says, Hadrian!
I'm sure that was actually, intended.
Who is Sylvester Stallone's favorite Roman emperor? He built a very large wall.
I have no idea.
Hadrian!
That's just... I'm glad that you, like, stick to doing, like, rap diss tracks and not, like...
Who is?
Uh-huh.
Who did Sylvester Stallone vote for to win the 2003 Oscar for Best Picture? I mean, Best Actor. That's very important.
So 2003. Who was in 2003...
Space Odyssey.
There's no way I'm going to be able to guess this, so just go ahead and say it.
Hadrian Brody. I loved you in The Pianist.
All right, that one was pretty good.
Thank you. Thank you.
That was good. Do you think Sly... Or celebrities in general, like action movie heroes in general. Do you think they go back and watch either their old movies or watch like their rivals' movies? Like not necessarily in like a antagonistic sort of way, but just like, oh, let me see how much better I did than Schwarzenegger.
Well, it's funny because like,
let me see how much better I did than Schwarzenegger.
From an action movie standpoint, Schwarzenegger crushed Stallone.
Right.
Commando, Terminator, Terminator 2, you know, he had a lot of...
Yeah.
Predator, yeah, these are like genuine good movies. What does Stallone have? I know people are going to say, oh, Demolition Man. It's not good, though. It's okay.
He's known for every Rocky movie.
Yeah, but those are like Best Picture nominee.
You wouldn't consider those action flicks? Mm-hmm. I mean, they're not. It's not really a shoot 'em up, of course, unless you're talking about Rocky 8, where Adrian... comes back from the dead Brody. And goes on. Yeah, Adrian Brody comes back from the dead and avenges the... Yeah. Wait, you went to Sweden?
I went to Sweden. That was only our fourth one.
That should have been fifth one, didn't it?
That was our fifth one?
Pretty apparently not. Why does this episode feel like it's taken like 30 minutes?
Probably because of the Adrian jokes.
Yeah, it's just...
You put us in Norway?
Yes.
Yeah, my brain was like only half in that one, to be
honest.
That's all right. I thought I was like, there's no chance. I'm just going to go full on in this Adrian bit.
I think that at this point, though, there actually is no chance. I might be untouchable in this one. Maybe. 14.6.
Not untouchable, but...
Unless if I bomb
extremely
it.
Extremely unlikely.
Okay.
Yeah, you'd have to get the... You'd have to be like an ocean away. Which, I mean...
My second favorite Flock of Seagulls.
An ocean. An ocean away. I don't think you're going to be an ocean away.
An ocean away.
I don't know that
one. That's like the quintessential one-hit wonder. But it's such a good song. Yeah, Iran
is a classic.
It's a great song. I challenge anyone to tell me that it's not a great song. It's great. It encompasses everything that was going on in the 80s, which I was not alive for.
There's a lot of classic 80s bangers. Cars by Gary Numan.
Yep.
People make fun of it, but it's really good.
I agree.
You know Echo and the Bunnymen?
No.
On the blue moon I saw you. So cruelly you kissed me.
You know them?
No.
Under the arm, too late to judge me.
You know them?
No.
Oh, cancel it, though. I know it I must be the killing time. Unwillingly. You know them?
I still don't know them. It doesn't matter how much of the song you keep singing.
Okay, we're getting to the chorus, though.
Okay.
Fate. Up against your will, through the thick and thin.
You know them?
Once there was this.
Oh yeah, dude, it is the same voice.
There was this band who was popular in 1980. Then they retired on Earth.
in 2000.
It gets more Stallone-ish.
For the soundtrack of the indie hit Donnie Darko.
I just imagine Sly singing that Crash Test Dummies bang.
He would kill it.
He probably actually would. Karaoke, man. Like, he actually probably would.
Mm-hmm. Once there was this kid who tried to be a boxer thanks to his girlfriend Adrian. What's Sylvester Stallone's favorite city in Turkey?
Istanbul. I don't know.
That's just rude. It's Edirne.
What I wanted for 30 seconds, I just wanted to see how you come up with these thoughts. Like, just enter your mind. Have I gone in a complete circle?
Did you get under 100 points?
Probably not, but I haven't made a guess yet. I've got like 10 seconds left.
What country do you think it is?
It's somewhere in South America. That's all I freaking know. Like,
nope, that's wrong. It's Australia.
I don't believe you. I'm just gonna say at the crossing
Northern Canada.
I'm gonna say the crossing between those three countries there. All right. Well, I was like way off. How did you figure out it was there?
There was a big sign that said Colombia.
Oh my gosh. If
only I hadn't fudged up the Sweden guess so badly, I was in there.
Yeah. That was close. I barely won without sandbacking. I'm sitting here trying my heart out while Northern Lion's making Stallone references, and he almost won. I gotta step
Well, hey, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. Subject the polls back to within one, and we'll see you tomorrow with a new one. See you then!
See you later!